Welcome again. Today we consider topic 2.5.6, define the terms and calculate the values of both gross primary productivity, GPP, and net primary productivity, NPP, from given data. Considering the second of those definitions, first, the net primary productivity, or the NPP, is the total gain in energy or biomass per unit of area, per unit of time, after allowing for losses from respiration. Here we see a set area, like the definition points out. Consider an area of maybe 1 square meter. Within this area, if we were able to measure the amount of growth in grams over a unit of time, like a year, then we would be quantifying the net primary productivity, the total increase in biomass per unit of area, per unit of time. But have we considered this part, the loss from respiration? For this growth to happen, and over a period of 1 week, maybe all of this growth can actually happen. For that growth to happen, plants need to carry out the process of photosynthesis, which means they take in carbon dioxide, they use light, they give out oxygen. When all of that happens, they produce glucose, which is used to build up starch and cellulose. It is this growth that goes into this increase in biomass, which can be quantified in grams per meter squared per week or year, as the case might be. Here, a week is more appropriate. As our plants grow over the week, they don't stop this important process of respiration. They carry out photosynthesis and respiration at the same time. So whatever growth they have, it's due to photosynthesis, but some of what they make is also consumed in respiration. So whatever is left over is the net productivity, or the NPP. Respiration is an ongoing process for the plant, but we can only quantify it when we turn off the lights and allow the plant to stop photosynthesizing. When this happens, we notice that the level of oxygen falls in our chamber and the level of carbon dioxide rises. This process of respiration is an ongoing process, but the fact that photosynthesis is happening faster than this process in the presence of light means that oxygen increases. In our small plot, the increase in biomass by the plants takes into account this loss from respiration, and whatever is left over is an accurate measure of the NPP. So, going back to our definition, the total gain in energy or biomass, which is what we measured, per unit of area after allowing for respiratory losses. We don't need to actually deduct anything because respiration is ongoing. It uses this glucose that is made in photosynthesis. That is an input of respiration. So this NPP, it's fairly easy to quantify because it's just a measure of how much growth happens with our plant here over a period of time in a specific area. The other definition, although shorter, is a bit more complicated to quantify. The total gain in energy or biomass per unit area, per unit time by photosynthesis in green plants. And it requires us to understand that respiration has to be included in this gross. Given our equation here, that the NPP is equal to the GPP minus respiration. And given the fact that we can measure the NPP and we can measure the rate of respiration like we've done here, then we can do some reverse engineering or work backwards and use this equation to calculate the GPP, making it the subject of this formula. We would find that GPP is equal to the net productivity by our plants plus the rate of respiration. And adding this and this and having both values with the same unit, we would be able to get the gross productivity. And this is the only way to do it, because it is impossible to shut off respiration in a living plant. And therefore, the only way to quantify GPP is by this indirect method. Let's apply our knowledge of GPP and NPP to an aquatic ecosystem. Consider this one right here. On day one, we go out and we take two samples off the water from this area. Surely there are lots of producers in this aquatic ecosystem, and these primary producers are algae. These algae carry out photosynthesis. The fact that oxygen is an output of photosynthesis is made use of. In both sample bottles, the dissolved oxygen level is used as an indirect way of measuring how much photosynthesis happens. So with two samples taken from a given spot on this lake, we measure with dissolved oxygen probes and find that one bottle contains 4.35 milligrams of oxygen per liter and the other one contains 4.23. We call one the light bottle and we call the other one the dark bottle. What we're going to do is to take these samples and leave them on the lake for a couple days, but we'll wrap this one up as we leave the bottles tied to a specific area, floating very much in the same area that we got them from, so that no light gets into one bottle. So our dark bottle would only be carrying out respiration. It would be a measure of the rate of respiration, measured indirectly by how much the oxygen level falls down in this bottle. And then our light bottle would be like our experiment here. And this increase in oxygen here is due to the fact that photosynthesis produces oxygen and we minus what respiration uses. So that's a measure of the NPP. So this would be an indirect measure of the NPP and this would be an indirect measure of the respiration. 2 days later, we came back to the same area and we measured our bottles for the level of dissolved oxygen. And this is what we got. Given our original definition, which asked for biomass, we would have to convert milligrams of oxygen into milligrams of actual carbon that was fixed by these autotrophic organisms, the algae that live in our pond. Your job is to calculate the NPP